Well, let's first take a look at what a floating rate security is. Typically, floating rate securities have coupons that are tied to a contractual spread over some type of short-term rate benchmark. Oftentimes, it's tied to three-month LIBOR. So as you see short-term rates rise, floating rate coupons will adjust to the rising rate. Now, with the Federal Reserve initiating a rate hike cycle, this has come into play recently. By definition, a floating rate instrument is short interest rate duration. So in a rising rate environment, particularly when the short end of the curve is moving higher, price volatility can be limited by investing in a floating rate instrument. Well, I think if you step back and look at the economic background in a rising rate environment, that typically signals a reasonable economic backdrop. Now, with that said, there's really two ways to mitigate the impact of rising rates. You can either shorten duration risk in the portfolio, or you can lengthen credit risk in the portfolio as well, or you can combine both. Now, let's take a look at the first. By shortening interest rate duration risk, you reel in the price volatility of your underlying assets in the portfolio in a rising rate environment. By lengthening credit risk, you take on additional credit risk spread. So as rates rise, that credit risk spread can act as a bit of a shock absorber. So as rates rise, spreads contract, and prices on the fixed income investments can remain in a tighter range. So really, those are the two mitigants to a rising rate environment: short interest rate risk and long credit risk.